Well, one of Mitt Romney's top surrogates during both his 2008 campaign and this one has been his oldest son, Tagg. Gwen and I spoke with the nominee's 42-year-old son just a short time ago. Tagg Romney, welcome to the NewsHour's coverage of this convention.
Thanks for having me on. Happy to be here.
Well, big day, a lot of pressure on your dad, especially. How is he dealing with it?
He's doing great. The real pressure actually was Tuesday night when my mom spoke. That's when he was the most nervous. It was her first ever prepared political speech. And so to have her get up there and knock it out of the park like that was what made all of us happy, but raised the bar for him.
In fact, today it was interesting. She spoke before a group here in Tampa, and she said, this is the convention, and you're seeing so many people you know. She said, it's kind of like going to your own funeral.
You know, we have 120 relatives in town from both, you know, a couple different families, and lots of friends we haven't seen in a long time, and people from the Olympics, and it's been a really fun experience to see all these people. It's kind of like, this is your life.
Maybe more like a wedding than a funeral.
Yeah, exactly. A better analogy, hopefully.
You and your four brothers and your mother, of course, are supposed to be character witnesses for your dad. What is it that people really need to know the most that they don't, the misconceptions they have right now?
You know, I think people know how good of a business person he was and how good he is at fixing budgets and turning things around. A lot of people don't recognize yet because they haven't really tuned in, is how good of a person he is. Obviously, we're his family. We love him. But he spent his life not only as a good father and a good husband, but very generous and has helped many people in their lives very quietly, off camera, not as political talking points, but because he genuinely wants to help people. And that's the side of Mitt Romney, I think, maybe hasn't come out as much as I'd like. But I think you'll maybe see a little bit more of that in the next few months.
Your dad has said in interviews, I am what I am. He seems to resist this idea that he should be sold like a piece of meat was the term.
Yeah.
But that's kind of your job, isn't it?
Well, it's my job and my mom's job. He doesn't like to get out there and try to, you know, he's taught that, you know, when you do something good, you don't stand up and brag about it. You let the actions speak for themselves. And I think he's lived his life that way. And he's not going to change just because he's running for office. And he's done a lot of great things that he doesn't really like to talk about. So that's why I'm here.
Well, you know, there's so much conversation, Tagg Romney, about how much more he should reveal himself. In fact, I think former Florida Governor Jeb Bush said today he needs to reveal more about himself. Do you think too much is made of that? What do you think?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, really what we're electing is someone who can get in there and get the job done. And the reason he's running, listen, he's a very good man. But there are lots of very good people. And the reason he's running is because he's in the position to do something about the challenges that our nation's facing. He thinks he can get the 23 million Americans who are out of work back to work, create 12 million jobs in 4 years. He thinks he can get the GDP growing again. He thinks he can help solve the big issues that are facing us, help us fix the broken education system that we have. Those are the reasons he's running. Those are the things he wants to talk about, not you know, what age he was when he learned to ride a bike.
Do you think we will learn more about him just from tonight's speech?
I think you will. I think you learned a lot about him when my mom spoke Tuesday night. She opened up, told a lot more stories than have been told in the past. I expect he'll talk a little bit about, I don't know for sure, but I expect he'll talk a little bit about his mom and his dad and the role that they played in his life. I think you'll see a little bit more revealed than he has in the past.
I watched your dad watching your mom deliver the speech the other night that you just referred to, and I was trying to read his face, and I don't know him well enough to know what was going through his head, but you've talked to him about this moment.
Yeah.
What would you say he's going through?
You know, this is a surreal experience for all of us. None of us expected ever to be here. You don't plan on having this happen, but it's he's doing this for the right reasons. He's not doing it because he wants to check a box or because he but he really is doing this because he feels like he's in a position to help fix the problems that America's facing. And as a result of that, you know, it's interesting, he's not worried about winning or losing. It's not weighing on him. He's not nervous about those things. He's just doing the best that he can. And as a result, he's pretty relaxed, I think. He's in a good place.
You just said you don't plan on having this happen. I understand not being able to be prepared for the moment, but if you run for president once and then twice, you weren't ever planning for this to happen?
Well, I mean, most of our lives, you know, I was 24 when he ran for office the first time. And so most of my life, he had just been dad. He was a business guy, but he was dad. And to have all these things kind of happen to your family all of a sudden, it's been in the last 10 years, really, that this has happened, and it's happened quickly. After he ran the first time, he wasn't sure that he was going to run a second time, and I think he probably thought he wasn't going to run. But I'm glad that he did. I think the country will be glad that he did. I think he'll be a great leader and really help get America back on track.
Tagg Romney, you are, I guess, 42 years old. Your father's running mate, same age.
42, yep. What he was born in January. I was born in March, 1970.
So he's a few months older. What did you think about that? I mean, about somebody your age being vice presidential?
I think it's wonderful. Paul Ryan is such a good man, good family man, but he's also so skilled and really knows what he's talking about. Like my dad, he's worried about the big issues that our country's facing, and he wants to get in there and fix them. And he's not worried about the day-to-day political battle and the, you know, this tweet versus that tweet and this political consultant said this and how about that. They're worried about the big issues that America's facing. And my dad was energized to have someone to get on that ticket with him who's marching towards the same goal that he is.
Led Zeppelin for you too?
Yeah, Paul and I are the same generation. So I'm not sure I would have picked AC/DC and Zeppelin as my two top bands, but we have the same generation.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
I was just going to say, when it was reported that Paul Ryan and your dad hit it off the first time they really spent time together, is that your understanding of what happened?
Yeah, and that's true for a lot of the people who he was considering to be his pick, but they definitely hit it off very well. It's funny watching the two of them on a bus together. They'll start talking about this tax policy and how it affects that, and they're very concerned about, you know, how does this affect the GDP growth and how does this affect the business world, and they speak on the same planes.
You went to Harvard Business School, and your father went to Harvard Business School. Have you ever considered following him into politics as well?
At one point, I thought about it about
really?
5 or 6 years ago, and then we've been through this process, and I have to be honest with you. I am now focused on raising my family and working on my career, and politics is probably not in my future. I live in Massachusetts and love it there, love the state. I'm a little bit more conservative than most of the population is there.
So was your dad.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
Yeah.
He had an extraordinary circumstance. The state was facing a huge budget deficit. He was the right person at the right time, so certainly not in my plans.
More conservative than your dad? Are you drawing any contrast there?
No, not at all. I'm not. My political views and things are my dad's running, not me. So you guys don't need to worry about me.
You said a minute ago that your dad was really nervous the other night when your mom spoke.
Yeah.
How is she dealing with tonight? What is she? What's
well,
she going through behind
nervous.
The scenes?
It's funny watching during the debates. We did. I don't remember how many debates we did in the Republican
side. A lot.
It was more. It was
more than 20.
Yeah. It was almost inhumane, but. She would get so nervous before every debate, much more nervous than he was, because when it's like having a child that's on a sporting field and you watch them and you're so nervous for them, you want them to do well, and she goes through the same thing. So I'm sure tonight she'll be nervous and crossing her fingers for him, saying little prayers for him, and rooting for him.
You're not only the eldest son and chief spokesman, bottle washer. You're also a close advisor and fundraiser for your father. How did you grow into that role?
You know, advisor is probably too strong of a word. Fundraiser, right?
Well, because he doesn't listen, or
no,
because
he's got a group of very good advisors who are very good at what they do. I just go where they tell me to go and do what they tell me to do and do my best to raise money for the cause. I'm just trying to be a good son and spend time where they need me to be.
When tonight is over, what do you want? What do you think the American people should know about your dad that maybe they haven't picked up before now?
I hope that they see the man that I know, the kind heart that he has, the largeness of his spirit, his love of country, his love of family, his love of fellow men, I hope those things come through. I think they'll come through not just tonight, but as people watch him in action. I know people want him to talk about the things that he's done. I think if they see him in the way he treats other people and the way he holds himself, I think those things will shine through not just tonight, but throughout the campaign.
What can you tell us about the big speech? Give us something.
I told you a little bit. He's going to talk about his mom and dad a little bit.
Yeah.
Anything else, you're going to have to tune in. I want your viewers to tune in and watch.
They will.
When he walks out on that extended, what was the purpose of the extended podium?
I have not seen it, so I have no idea. So I'll be in suspense like you guys are.
we will be listening from this very position. Thank you for taking time to
Thanks
come
for
and visit
me
us.
Yeah,
Tagg Romney,
it.
Thank you very much.
Thank
it's
you.
So good to have you with us.
Thanks.